your move.
I know, Pop.
Can I help you?
Do you keep copies of all the pictures you take?
Most of them.
How long?
I still have the first wedding picture I took over 30 years ago.
Both my parents have died and no one in the family has a good picture of them. Now, when we were kids, I seem to remember coming here to have pictures taken.
I know you. Little Johnny Rico.
Yeah, that's right.
Don't go away. Stay right there. Michael, come here, quick. I've got a surprise for you. I'll bet you don't remember him.
Hello, Johnny.
Hello, Mike.
You remember him?
Johnny's not a guy you forget easily.
He wants a picture of his mother and father. I have it in the cellar. It will take a little while to find it and make some prints. Say, the day after tomorrow.
Fine. Either I'll pick them up or my girl will.
They will be ready.
Same girl, Johnny?
Same girl.
I'll give my best to Lorraine.
I always give Lorraine the best.
Hey, Johnny. You've spilled a lot of blood, haven't you?
I've had to. Climbing on top of a tough business, Mike. I'll be there in a couple of days.
Right, get some more.
Get out of my way!
With a Camera. Starring Charles Bronson.
The police investigated, but there wasn't much they could do. Johnny Rico had stepped on some important toes trying to climb to the top, and he was dead. I hope that was the end of it. Hello. This is Mike Kovac.
This is Lorraine Nelson.
Oh, Johnny said you were in town, but I thought I'd hear from you last night.
Mike, I've got to see you. I just have to talk to somebody.
Can you come over now?
Well, I've got some business appointments. Oh, but I guess I can break them. What's the address?
I'm at the St. Mark's Hotel.
All right, I'll be there in an hour. Bye.
So we were going to be married. As soon as Johnny finished what he had to do.
Sure you were.
There was a lot of good in Johnny, Mike.
Sure there was.
The police questioned me most of last night. They told me he pushed you out of the way so you wouldn't be killed.
He pushed me out of the way because I was blocking his gun hand.
Hated him, didn't you?
No. I didn't think anything about him. I hated what he stood for, the way he made his money.
I loved him.
Well, that's your business, Lorraine, but I'll tell you right now, Johnny was an out-and-out hood.
I don't care what names you call him. I loved him, and I want to see somebody pay for what they did.
Well, I wish I could help you, but I'm a photographer and not a detective.
But you can help me, Mike.
How?
We've been here 5 days now. We made the nightclubs, saw some shows, did all the usual things, except one.
What's that?
Night before last, we rode out to Riverbank, to a big mansion. Johnny stayed there for a few minutes. Came out. We came back to Manhattan.
Riverbank. Wow. That was way over Johnny's head. You know, he wasn't exactly in the 400.
He said he had a meeting. Something big.
Go on.
Said he was going to move up. Carve himself a big slice.
That's very funny. Somebody carved him instead, huh?
And I want that somebody, Mike.
Lorraine, so do the police.
Not as much as me.
But why pick on me?
Who else is there? Who do I know?
Who do you know? You know lots of people. This is New York, your hometown, remember?
Lots of people. A lot of people who turned their backs on me. Written me off. Have you?
No.
Then help me.
Lorraine, I'll do what I can for you, but I can't make any promises.
In high school, Johnny was your friend.
Listen, in high school, Johnny stole my first camera to buy you an orchid. We drove up and down and in and out for over an hour. I guess the thing that intrigued me most was not finding out who gunned Johnny Rico, but who in Riverbank would let him in the front door.
That's the house.
Well, that's good. What now?
I don't know. Couldn't you go in and find out who lives there?
I wouldn't even get past that gate.
Mike.
Did you see who was in there? That was Big Joe Tenuto. This meeting Johnny said he was going to. Did he say who was going to be there?
He said everybody was. He didn't mention any names, but... Mike.
Recognize him?
I met him once in Hot Springs. His name is Frank Gilson.
Wow, Frank Gilson and Big Joe Tenuto. I'd sure like a picture of those two for my scrapbook.
They sure drive big cars, don't they, Mike?
Yeah. Lorraine, looks like every top wood in the country's gonna be here. I wonder why.
I don't know.
Well, I don't know either. But it's building into something.
What are you gonna do?
I'm just going to ask them to watch the birdie. You wait here in the car and keep the motor running.
They won't let you take their pictures.
Oh, there's a lot of people that are camera shy if they see the camera.
Okay, Buster. You had your fun. Come on down.
You talking to me?
Come on, wise guy. This is private property. Don't make any trouble for us. We won't make any trouble for you.
All right. That's fair enough.
Enough. What'd you hit me with? You a newspaper man?
No, I'm a freelance photographer.
Frankly, we regard your action as an invasion of privacy, and we like our privacy.
You know, I knew I had something when I snapped the first picture.
You weren't invited, Mr. Kovac.
Bookmaking, dope, women, protection. Every man a king, and I got the whole royal family on one roll of film.
We want it back.
Did your friend tell you I got rid of it?
Yeah, he did.
You know, if you're as smart as people say you are, then you know that all I have to do is get up and walk out of here.
You should have kept the pictures.
Yeah, but I didn't.
That might have been a mistake. Pardon me.
Hello.
This is Lorraine. Who's this?
It doesn't make much difference who you're talking to, Lorraine.
That's right. Because I'm going to talk and you're going to listen.
You've got 24 hours to turn in the man who killed Johnny, understand?
And if we don't?
Then I turn Kovac's roll of film over to the police.
I see.
Then you'd better see this, too.
I haven't got it on me. It's locked up. The key has been entrusted to a lawyer. So if anything should happen to me, he's to turn the roll of film over to the police.
We'll be in touch with you. You're free to go.
Thanks.
However, I think you should know that she didn't turn those photos over to the police.
Well, I don't believe that.
The young woman is quite inventive. She knows how much damage could be done if certain crime committees could link the gentlemen in this house together.
You mean she's going to sell them back to you?
For a price, a very big price.
How much?
She's given us 24 hours to turn the killer of Johnny Rico over to the police.
Well, looks like she's got you over a barrel.
Oh, she's got the barrel all right, but you're the one that's over it.
What do you mean I'm over it?
You took the pictures, Mr. Kovac. You've got the same 24 hours to bring them back.
Suppose I can't.
The man who got Rico will collect another fee.
I'm glad they let you go, Mike.
Oh, they've still got a string on me.
And I'm sorry about the beating you took. But now that you're out of it, stay out of it.
Out of it? They've given me 24 hours to turn over that film or I follow your boyfriend.
Oh.
Oh? Is that all you can say?
I've got to think.
There's nothing to think about. You just give me the film and I'll turn it over to them.
Then nobody will pay for killing Johnny.
Let the police worry about that.
This way I can be sure. If those pictures are released, every one of those men will be in trouble. Big trouble, and they all know it. They can't do anything but turn in the murderer.
There's something else they can do. They can kill me.
I'm sorry, Mike. But I've hidden your negatives, and they're going to stay hidden.
What kind of a woman are you? Just to get the guy that knocked off your boyfriend, you're willing to have me end up in a box.
I'm willing to do anything for Johnny.
Well, am I going to have to shake them out of you?
It won't do you any good. I've been belted around by the best of them.
You really think you have them scared?
They're running out of time, Mike. So I know they're running scared.
Well, it's me that's scared. I know exactly where I'm running.
That's what I figured. Well, keep a watch anyway. House was empty, Mike.
I could have told you that.
Send out an APB. Have them look for Tenuto and Gilson, anybody else who shouldn't be in town.
Yes, sir.
We can keep you in protective custody.
No, thanks.
I think it's a smart thing to do.
I don't.
They've given me until 5 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. Spending my time in a jail cell won't help me get that film back.
We're doing a run on the girl, finding out who she knows in town, who she might have entrusted those pictures to. If we don't come up with anything, we'll haul her in.
What good will it do, Lieutenant? She's going to give you the film anyhow if they don't turn in Johnny Rico's killer.
Last night you told me this girl was a friend of yours.
I thought so, too, last night.
There's always a chance, Mike, that the last second she'll have a change of heart.
Oh, Lieutenant, if the girl had a heart, I wouldn't be in this spot.
This is Lieutenant Fields. Mike Kovac just left my office. Keep a tail on him.
Welcome home. You haven't got the pictures.
I'll get them.
You went directly from the meeting to see Lorraine. From there, you went to the policeman back here.
Any objections?
Bringing the police into this wasn't a very smart thing to do.
Well, it was if you look at it from my side.
Mike? Is it all right if I call you Mike?
Mr. Kovac, if it's all the same to you.
Mike, you're running out of time. Now, I sent a representative to interview Lorraine. They talked to her, but she refused to turn over the negatives.
You know, beating her up can only make her madder.
Just convinced us that she had better live. Smart girl, Lorraine. Somebody knows a secret as to where she's hidden the film.
A friend.
A lawyer, we don't know.
Well, neither do I.
I was just trying to impress you with the fact that you had better find out.
Well, it wasn't necessary because I'm already impressed. It was no longer a matter of who killed Johnny Rico, but who might kill me. There was no point in running, so I drove around most of the night, trying to think of a way to protect myself. All the next day, I looked up Lorraine's old friends, anyone who might be keeping the film for her. There was no luck. Finally, with only a few hours to go, I came up with a plan.
Care to go a couple of rounds with you, Mike?
Wouldn't do any good.
That's what those hoods said. But they had to prove it for themselves.
We've got 1.5 hours left, Lorraine.
Yes? For you.
Yeah. No, she won't give them to me, Lieutenant. What? Oh, that's great. That's real great. No, no. Don't pick me up. I'll get those negatives.
You won't, Mike.
Big Joe Tenuto just took a room down at the Renaud Hotel. He's got a cop outside his door at his own request.
That doesn't make sense.
It does make sense. It gives him a great alibi when I'm killed.
I won't give you the pictures, Mike.
All right. Operator, give me the Renaud Hotel. Room 909, please. Joe, this is Mike Kovac.
You got the pictures, Kovac?
She won't turn them over to me.
You're digging your own grave, Mike.
Yeah, I'm digging a grave. But I'm going to push you right in it, you and all your friends.
What do you mean?
You've got 1.5 hours to turn over Johnny Rico's killer.
Are you out of your mind?
1.5 hours, or I kill Lorraine. It's so simple, I almost missed it.
Put the gun down, Mike.
This is like a game of button-button. Who's got the button? You turn the pressure on them, they turn it on me, and now I turn it on you.
To protect myself. That's why I did it, Mike.
Yeah, that's why I got the gun on you, too. Now it's my turn.
You wouldn't use it.
Lorraine, in 1.5 hours. 5 o'clock, straight up. You'll get your answer.
You won't pull that trigger.
Do you think I like what you've done to me? Huh? You think I like the picture of myself with a gun in my hand? I don't. You've got 15 minutes to find out one thing. Just how far a man can be pushed. How much pressure he can take before he forgets everything that's decent in him and he explodes into an animal. You've got my back right up against the wall, and you nailed it there. I can see only one way to pull free. One minute.
Mike, will you please listen to me? Killing me won't do you any good.
The pictures, Lorraine. Where are they?
Please, Mike.
Now we'll find out how dead you really are. Sit still. Mike Kovac. What? Yeah, she's still alive. Well, it'll take me about an hour till I check the story and to get the film. Hit my place. Don't mention it. Well, they've just delivered your boyfriend's killer in a sack to the 49th precinct.
Are you sure?
Well, I will be when I call the police. Now, where's the film? Kid yourself. If there'd been any other way, I'd have turned that film in myself.
May I have them? Now, I hope these are the right ones, because before I destroy them, I'm going to have them developed just to make sure.
When you do, you'll notice I snipped a couple off at the end of the roll.
What?
I wanted at least one good one for my scrapbook.
Why?
Insurance.
Or it had better never turn up in a newspaper or a magazine.
It won't.
I don't know how much you'd get for it, but that's the price you'd be putting on your life.
Mr. Tenuto, like I said, insurance.
Now, you're a smart boy, Mike. You stay smart.
He's gone.
How'd it come out?
Take a look. I made an agreement, Lieutenant. I made a deal with a man, and I double-crossed him.
I recognize all these men, big operators. We've never had evidence that linked them together. You made a deal with no good hoodlums.
And by breaking my word, I put myself right in their category.
I admire your moral stand, Mike. I think it's fine. I recommend you stick to it when you make deals with moral people.
It still doesn't let me off the hook.
And look at it like this. A lot of people, innocent people, will go right on living because we have a copy of this picture.
Yeah, I guess you're right there. If this picture gets in the newspapers or the magazines, I'm a dead man. You know that, don't you?
It's too valuable to publish, Mike. When the right time comes, we'll drag him in and have all the evidence we need without this.
Well, that's good enough for me.
You've done us a big favor. We won't forget it.
Oh. In that case, I got a parking ticket, Lieutenant. What do I do about it?
Pay it, Mike. It's only $5.
Just a minute. You know, I take pictures for a living.
So?
It's only $5. Pay it. Goodbye, Lieutenant.